वेलकम टू दिस कोर्स ऑफ कोर्स ऑन डिजिटल सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग. नाउ फ्रॉम टुडे वी विल गो फॉर द यूनिट नंबर 4. सो यूनिट नंबर 4 इज़ डेडिकेटेड फॉर डिजिटल फिल्टर्स एंड द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द डिजिटल फिल्टर्स. सो लेट अस सी व्हाट इज फिल्टर. So filter is, it is essentially a network that selectively changes wave shape of the signal in a desired manner. So basically there are two types of filters. One is the analog filter, another is the digital filter. So analog filter is made up from the analog components, where we have resistor, capacitor, inductor, operational amplifiers and different type of resistors also. And analog filters are categorized by, or the mathematically it is modeled by, Laplace transform, that is H of S, that is transfer function in S domain. Okay, from second year you are studying filters. First in electronic devices and circuits you have studied the filters, where you have studied the filters in the power supply design, where you have seen the RC filter, PI filter, choke input LC filter, C filter, that is inductor filter, PI filter and so on. Then in operational amplifier we can design the filters, but that part is not covered in your syllabus of ADIC, that is again at the fourth same level. It is covered in EEE syllabus. Okay, so and in day to day life we use the filters in different type of aspects. We use the filter when we use the microphone. So microphone is one of the type of filter also, because it reduces the noise. So basically the filter always go for the noise reduction and to make the signal more, means it is to use it is used to improve the quality of the signal, especially in the radio we are using filter, in mobile phone to improve the voice quality we are using the filter, and this is what the filters are, nothing but analog filters. And now in day-to-day life again we use the filters to remove the impurity of the water, from the water we use different type of filters. We use aqua guards, we use different type of, just like what a filter, and while making tea we use the filter, because when we make tea then the tea loses becomes noise. For that we are only interested in the liquid form, so to remove that tea loose after the making of the tea we use filter. So we are basically using the filters from our, in our body also there are different type of filters. Okay, that is our what, excretory organs, in the form of different type of byproducts of our body, that is nothing but the filtered out. And the useful part is absorbed in the body, unwanted part is removed from the body. So this is the filter and its different type of aspects. So what are the objectives of the filter? So objectives of the filter is to remove noise, and to it is used to extract the information from the signal. Okay, and now what is digital filter? That is our part of interest in this unit. So digital filter is nothing but mathematical algorithm implemented in hardware and software that operates on a digital input to produce digital, desired digital output. Okay, so what is a digital filter? It is a mathematical algorithm. So algorithm means there are certain steps to be followed while designing the filter, because we have to collect the specification of the filters in order to design it properly. Then we have to follow certain steps mathematically and practically also to design any type of digital filter. Okay, but it is essentially a software which is implemented in the hardware as per the definition that is written here. So you can easily understand this concept, what is digital filter. And basically digital filter is designed, it is specified by H of Z, that is transfer function in Z domain, whereas the analog filter is defined or it is represented by transfer function in S domain. So while designing the filter, we have assumed that the system is linear time invariant system, because unless and until we assume the system to be linear time invariant, we are not in a position to express the digital filter or analog filter in the form of H of Z or in the form of H of S, that is Z domain and S domain respectively, for digital filter as well as analog filter. Okay, so these filters are often operates on digitized analog signal. See here, the word is very important, digitized analog signal, store in a computer memory. Okay, so basically we are interested in, again in the previous unit we have seen discrete time processing of continuous time signal. So same concept of discrete time processing of continuous time signal is applicable here. Okay, so these filters are often operates on a digital analog signal stored in a computer memory. So what are the applications? So there are various applications. One is the data compression, another is the speech processing, image processing, video processing. These are the applications of the filters, basically digital filter, because we are studying digital signal processing. So we are focusing ourselves on digital domain. We are not interested in analog domain, but still analog domain will help us in order to design the filter. Okay, so next is, so what are the advantages of digital filter? Why we are going for the digital filters? So first, the performance of digital filters does not vary with external environmental changes. So as the digital filter is applied in a software, so software does not change with respect to the external environment. Okay, so several signals can be filtered out without need of hardware. So this is another advantage. Okay, so and it is what implemented using the computers, using different type of microprocessor or DSP processors and so on. So DSP processor we have to see in the last unit. So next is, but as you always know, there is always disadvantages of particular system, though there is are some advantages. So what are the disadvantages? So first of all, long processing time required. Why long processing time? Because we have to first design analog filter in S domain, that is Laplace transform domain, and then we are converting S domain to Z domain. Again here we are doing the discrete time processing of the continuous time signal. So that's why the time requirement are on the higher side. And next is speed limitation. So we are the speed limitations also. And the another disadvantage I have not mentioned here. So basically digital filters are expensive. Why? Because we need hardware, we need computer, we need microprocessor, we need DSP processors, as well as we are going for the software also. Okay, so these are the disadvantages of the digital filter. Okay, then we will move forward. So what are the categories of the digital filter? So here it is written, it is FIR, that is finite impulse response filter. Another one is the IIR, that is infinite impulse response filters. So basically these are the two categories of the digital filters, finite impulse response and infinite impulse response. If you concentrate on these three words, finite impulse response. You know the impulse response from unit number 1, that is h of n. So in case of FIR filters, h of n is finite. Finite means which can be counted, which is in the particular limits. But what in case of IR filter, that is infinite impulse response, in IR filter we are having impulse response, that is h of n is infinite. Infinite means which cannot be counted. Okay, so these are the two categories of the digital filters, IR filter and FIR filter. We have to focus on these two filters. Next is structure of the digital filter. First one is FIR structure. So we have direct form 1, direct form 2, cascade, parallel. It is also known as frequency sampling. Last one is the lattice. So the last one is not in our syllabus, so we will focus on ourselves on direct form 1, direct form 2, cascade, parallel or frequency sampling. Then the construction of the IR filters are, so IR filters, again the same structures we are having: direct form 1, direct form 2, cascade, parallel or frequency sampling and lattice. Okay, so these are the structures of the FIR as well as IR filter. Then now we will stop our discussion here and we will go for the next part of this unit, that is how to obtain direct form 1 and direct form 2. So we will quickly revise this session. So we have started our journey from filter. So filter is essentially a network that selectively changes wave shape of the signal in a desired manner. I have given many examples regarding filters. So what are the basic objectives of the filter? To remove noise, to extract information from the signal. Okay, next we have seen the digital filters. So digital filters are nothing but hardware plus software, and we are assuming for the digital filter we should have h of z with us. H of z means transfer function of the digital system in the z domain. Okay, so digital, we are focusing ourselves on the digital filter discussion. So often operates on digital analog signals and stored in a computer memory. We have seen the various applications: data compression, speech processing, image processing, video processing. Okay, we have discussed the advantages of digital filters. The most advantageous part is it is not susceptible to external environmental changes. It works at its own. There is no any abrupt changes due to the external environment. Several signals can be filtered without need of hardware. This is another advantage, because just we have to make changes in the software and that will produce desirable results. But there are some disadvantages. We have discussed this: long processing time and speed limitation. Next one is we have categorized the filters FIR, IR. Then we have seen the structures, not structures only, name of the structures. In the next part of the discussion we will go for the details of the structure: direct form 1, direct form 2, cascade, parallel and lattice. Lattice part is not in our syllabus, so we will skip that part. Then we have seen the IR filter structure, same as that of FIR filter. Okay, so that completes our discussion and we will move forward from this.